Hello and welcome to the Hockey Shot Velocity Calculator. This video is going to take a look at streaming video from minor hockey league games in Toronto. Around 2017, the company gameON started installing cameras in a number of the rinks in and around Toronto and putting this footage online so customers could watch the games either in real time or later on demand. But it was only this year that I got around to checking it out for myself. And I would say I was pleasantly surprised in some ways and mildly disappointed in others with the product. What I'm gonna talk about today though is one of the pleasant surprises, and that is the extent to which you can visualize the speed of a shot in these game footage clips. So, just how hard was this shot? So let's take a closer look at that and find out just what we can learn from this video footage. The puck is seen clearly on each frame, but you'll also notice a couple duplicate frames, and that appears to be something about the gameON strategy of decimating their raw footage to a lower frame rate in order to conserve bandwidth. Nonetheless, we can clearly see the duration of this shot, which we're going to need to calculate velocity. What about the distance then? Here we've got a slightly more difficult problem introduced by the lens distortion of the video camera. In order to measure that shot distance D, we're going to need to correct for that lens distortion in some manner. That could be done from first principles using the physics of optics and lenses, but I don't have the chops for that. Instead, I'm going to use a quick and dirty method with a scale drawing of the rink, as seen here. We can get the goal to blue line distance, L, from the overall length of the rink. These lengths are tabulated for the public city facilities in a document like this one, or they can be looked up online for a private facility. Next, I'm going to measure the distance R from the center of the goal line to a number of locations in the offensive zone indicated by the gray dots. Those same locations can be identified and measured on a still from the video camera. The last step is to fit an interpolating function using thin plate splines. This will allow us to measure a distance on the distorted camera view and calculate the true linear distance, at least to an approximation. VLC is a free media player that we can use to count the number of frames that make up the shot duration. Tee up the beginning of the shot by using the slider bar on the bottom and then typing the E key to advance frame by frame. Take a snapshot to record that initial frame. Now step through the frames one by one, again typing E, and count the total number of frames for the shot duration. Lastly, check the frame rate of the clip. The GIMP is an open source image editor that we can use to measure the shot distance in the distorted camera coordinates. We'll load the frame zero snapshot recorded with VLC into the GIMP and use the measurement tool to get the distance from the center of the goal line to the puck. make a note of the XY camera coordinates down near the bottom of the GIMP screen. Note that the position of the puck on the final frame of the shot is not actually on the center of the goal line. Instead, it will be somewhere in the crease wherever the goalie makes the save. We're going to need an independent guess or estimate of this final puck position. I'm going to call that the save distance. For example, if the goalie saved the puck right on the edge of the crease, the save distance would be the radius of the crease, 6 feet. So in this clip that we're looking at, on the 10th frame of the shot, the puck has just hit the goalie's blocker and bounced off to the right. The position of the blocker is more or less over the edge of the crease, so the save distance here is 6 feet. On the other hand, if a goal was scored, the last frame of the shot might show the puck inside the net behind the goal line. In that case, the save distance would be a negative number. In essence, the save distance is a fudge factor, reflecting the quick and dirty nature of the spline approximation for shot distance. Now we can go ahead and put all this together with the hockey shot velocity calculator, found on Google Sheets at the link given in the description below. Here I've tallied the spline fit approximation for each of the available netcams in the GTHL. First, select the rink from the list of sheets at the bottom. Then, enter the data points recorded in the previous few steps. XY camera coordinates, the save distance, the frame rate, frames per second, and the number of frames for the shot duration.